Welcome back everybody to another 92 plates video. This one is highly requested. It is a dough recipe. However, I do need to let you know that the dough recipe is not my own recipe. It is by a 13-time pizza champion, Tony Gemignani, and he has very kindly allowed me to use the recipe that is in his book for this video right now. There are a few things I have changed just to help speed up my workflow. However, if you want to know the exact method and the exact recipe from a 13-time pizza champion, then go ahead and buy this book. I'll put the link in the description below. So thank you very much, Tony Gemignani, for allowing me to use your recipe. Let's roll the tape. Okay, welcome to day one of our dough making recipe. Now, this is going to take around 48 hours for us to make this dough because it's a fermentation process and we want to really build up that flavor inside of the dough. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take 70 grams of lukewarm water and mix in 4.5 grams of active yeast. We're going to really mix that up till we get a nice froth on the top. We're going to pop that to one side because we need the yeast to start working and start to activate. So whilst that yeast is doing its thing, we're going to add 450 grams of flour to a bowl. Take 225 grams of ice cold water, add 9 grams of fine sea salt into it and dilute that into the water and add that to your flour. So once you've added the water to the flour, mix that up so it starts to combine. If you don't have a stand mixer, don't worry. Use the handle of a wooden spoon. This is actually a tip that I got from my boss and it works perfectly. So once you have mixed all of this up and the water and the flour have combined, then pour in that beautiful yeast liquid into the mix and give it another stir to bring it all together. Let's get dirty at this point. Get your hands in there and start kneading inside the bowl. So once you've kneaded for about a few minutes, just to really get that dough together, add 5 grams of olive oil and get your hands back in there and incorporate that oil into the dough. Now at this point, I need you. Haha, get it? Need? I need you. Okay, right, we'll move on. We want to get that dough as smooth as possible, so pop that onto the counter and let's start kneading that dough. We're going to knead it for about 10 minutes. We really want to get that gluten network going because that's going to make our dough nice and fluffy as well. So once we start getting that kneading going, all the ingredients are going to incorporate together even more to create a nice little sexy bit of dough. So once you've kneaded this for about 10 minutes, if you're doing it by hand, roll the dough into a nice little ball and use a dough scraper to take it from the units and place that dough into a bowl. So we're going to add a funny little bowl hat here. You can use cling film, anything to just make that airtight top. And we're going to put this into the fridge for 24 hours and do not touch that dough. Don't touch it for 24 hours until we come on to the next part. Day two. So after sitting in the fridge for 24 hours, take your dough ball baby out of the fridge and it should have formed this nice little belly at this point. We are going to degas the dough. And what this means is we're going to push all the air that has accumulated through the fermentation out of the dough. So we're going to scrape the dough onto a lightly floured surface and press down on it to remove all of the air. As you do this, you should hear pops and wheezes as that gas escapes. This is normally the moment that you would split your dough. So if you're making Neapolitan pizzas, you'll want to split it into two. If you're making other pizzas, you may want to split it into different portions. I'm using this for a Detroit style pizza, so I'm leaving this in a big ball. But if you are making more pizzas, then obviously split the dough into the portions that you need at this point. Once you've degassed and split your dough, ball them back up and put them into a proven container, an airtight container, or back into the bowl, cover with cling film, put that funny hat back on it, whatever it is, you need to make that airtight again. And we're going to put this back into the fridge for 24 hours. Just a couple of tips before we go and before you actually cook your pizzas, bring all of your ingredients out 1 to 2 hours before you actually want to cook. What this is going to do is bring all of your ingredients to room temperature and it will provide a nice even cook. Whilst if it's cold in the middle, then it's going to be colder in the middle, cook on the outside, not on the inside, and you can just get very confused with everything. So just make sure that you bring everything out, bring that up to room temperature. The last thing is that
at this stage, when you actually come to make your pizzas, if you're making Neapolitan pizzas, for example, don't try and degas that ball too much. Obviously, degas the middle, because that's where all your toppings are going to go. But leave the crust, try and allow some air in the crust, because what that is going to do is that's going to allow that to puff up and be nice, light, fluffy, and bouncy as well. So just a couple of tips there when you come to actually cook your pizzas. One last thing before I go is, if you're not subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button and also hit that bell icon as well, so you get notified when I drop videos like this all the time, because you don't want to miss them. I've got so much content that I've got lined up, a lot of pizza content as well that I've got lined up. So make sure that you got that bell icon turned on so you get notified when I drop these videos. If you do like this video, please give it a like, give it that good old thumbs up. I always like to see those thumbs up. And also, if you do try this out, if you do try the recipe out, if you do try the dough out, or any of my other recipes that I have on my channel, then comment below, let me know how it goes. Pop over to my socials, tag me in your pizza posts, send me images, everything. Just let me see what you create, because I love to see what people make on pizzas. But anyway, again, thank you very much to Tony Gemignani for allowing me to use his recipe in this video. The link for the pizza Bible for that book is below. Please go click on it. Please go and buy that book. Enjoy. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Peace out.